Hey guys, welcome to another prop tutorial by the Creative Bird. Today we're going to be working on a Ump.45 with a pull-out magazine, a workable trigger, a side bolt action that retracts back into its regular form, and sights. This tutorial was requested by J.Dobbin625. A small and big wooden dowel, a Dremel or a hacksaw you can use to cut the wooden dowel, and if you're going to use a Dremel, please be sure to wear proper safety equipment. A click pen you can take apart that has a spring in it, a pencil for sketching and measurements, a hot glue gun, a sharp cutting utensil, black acrylic paint, foam core poster board or cardboard, a rubber band that can be used to make the sliding mechanism, a small piece of cereal box cardboard, and a picture reference provided in the description. For the making of the Ump.45, what you're going to do is you're going to take your foam core poster board and you are going to go onto the picture and get all the dimensions and the measurements, and you're going to draw the main face of the body onto the foam core poster board, and then you're going to cut it out, and I will show you what I have done once I have drawn out the dimensions and all the measurements of it. As you can see, I have drawn out the first sketch and cutout of the Ump.45. I have the stock and I have the main body. So now, after I've completed doing this, now I'm going to cut out these two holes in here. See, the real one has it's decently thick, probably around that thick. Plus, it has two extra layers that add on to that that go over it, so that this part here that goes around the holes kind of sticks out a little bit more. I'm not going to do that because that just adds a little bit more difficulty, but I'm just going to cut this out, the holes in here out, and then I'm going to flip this and the hole gun and flip both of them and trace them one more time. And I'm going to cut them out, and then we're going to start working on the trigger, the backslide mechanism for loading it, and the magazine so that it can come out easily and it won't just fall out all the time, though, so we can actually make a mechanism to hold it in place. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to trace this out and cut it out one more time. And now what I've done is I've measured the thickness that I want, which is going to be 3 centimeters right to there, and I drew it right here, and then I marked a long strip. So now I'm going to cut this out and I'm going to curl it to fit the holes in here. So I'm going to mold it around the holes on the inside of the gun and glue them in, cutting them down to size, meaning I'll cut them down to size, I'll roll them on the sides, and then once I'm finished doing that, then I'm going to do the exact same thing I did here and cut more strips and mold them to fit all the way around the outer part of it. And then I'm going to glue that onto this part here, and then I'll be done with the stock, and then I can move on to the main body with all of its stuff. Alright, as you can see, just to demonstrate, this is what I've done for the stock. I cut out the 3 centimeter wide long foam core poster board band, and I proceeded to just bend it over and over again, all the parts on one direction, so that it curls inward in kind of a spiral shape. And then I cut it to the correct length for the stock and for the little hole here. And then I shaped it while hot gluing, meaning I'd hot glue a little spacing here, press down, glue the next spacing, and just kept going. And then afterwards, just to keep it secure, I ran hot glue all around this part, and then while it was still hot, I used the heated metal on the hot glue gun just to make sure that there's no hot glue sticking out. And now I'm going to proceed to do this one more time right here. And then we are going to make an overall big band to go all around the whole outer part of it. And then we're just going to glue the other layer of the stock onto that. And then we'll have the completed stock. We just have to make the front part here, which is very simple. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do now. Here's the two layers with the fully, all the braces inside, fully done. So
what I have here is I have the first layer, and then I have those rims that went all around these holes here, and then I have a brace in the front, and then I have another layer on top of that. So here is, and then also I have strips of foam core poster board going around the very edges, glued to both of these. So it is very strong. I mean, very strong, because it's very braced. So what we're gonna do once we're actually close to finishing the gun is we're gonna paper mache everything. So some of these, little ridges in here, and there's a few cracks in the foam core and stuff like that. Well, they're not gonna be visible. Everything's gonna be like everything's gonna be paper mache'd, and I'm gonna sand it down and paint everything black. So now we have one of the key components to the gun, the stock ready, and now we just need to make the actual gun, which is a lot more tricky than making this. So we're going to begin by working on the pullback loading handle thing, where you go like, we're just gonna work on that. I'm not sure what it's called, but yeah, that's what we're gonna be working on next for the main body, and then we're gonna be working on the trigger and a few other components. Alright, so what we're working on next is we're going to be working on the side bolt that goes like this. You pull back and it retracts back into its original form. And it is about right here somewhere. So that's what we're going to be working on next. And it's going to be the inside of this layer here. Alright, just to clarify something though, when I'm making the side bolt that goes back and snaps back in place, I'm not going to be able to make a bolt lock because I do not have enough spacing on the top to do so. So it's just going to go back to normal. It's not going to be able to lock. So yeah, that's just what I wanted to clarify quickly. Alright, so I finished making the top for the side slide mechanism. As you can see, there it is. So I'm going to tell you now how I did it. So as you can see here, this is the rubber band, this little kind of stick thing going this way. It's the rubber band, and this long piece going this way, that is the piece of wood that is kind of like a pillar. It's right here, I'll show you. Sorry, this is a little difficult. Okay, so that piece here is the wooden piece that is glued firm in place, and it's going to go all the way through to the other foam core poster board cutout of the gun. And so this piece is going to be glued to both sides. As you can see, it's got glue right here, which means this part's going to be what the elastic band stretches off of, going with this piece. So let's put it into an angle that you'll understand. So here, one minute. So as you can see, that little piece sticking out right there, yeah, and there, is this piece here. So how this works is this piece stays put, it doesn't move, but this piece here slides all the way to there with the elastic band. And once you let go, it snaps back in place next to this piece, which is the pillar. And it's got a track, which is this long rectangle piece here that it glides through, and then once you let go, it snaps back in place and it will not move. And in order to keep it from twisting and turning after I put on the elastic band, then I put on the top part here of the gun, just so that this piece here, as you can see, this is the piece connected to this piece to keep it from twisting and turning and not doing its function. So just to show you what I did after that is I cut out a long rectangle that is a little bit bigger, has a little bit bigger perimeter than this cutout here, this rectangle. And this piece, as you can see, I'm tapping on it right now, was glued to this piece, the one that moves back and forth. And so why I did that is so that when you pull, when it snaps back in place, all you can see is white. But when you pull back, this piece that's inside of the rectangle goes with it, and you can see inside of the gun. So that's just an effect I did. And then this piece here, it is a little bit bigger, and what it is for is to keep this from bending upward, because I've had a few guns that the foam core poster board has peeled. So I just made this little brace here that goes like that, just to kind of push it down. And then these are just to keep it on the track, going back and forth in a smooth motion. So that is what I did for this. And in a second, I'll demonstrate how this all works, like just show you that it works. And now, right here, that is the trigger guard. Well, for the making of the trigger, I'll go into detail in a second. For the making of the trigger, what I did is I cut out three layers here, and I have another three layers. And together, the three other layers with these three layers equals 3 centimeters, which is the exact same width as this piece here, which is going to be the length of the foam core poster board piece running all along this side, connecting it to the other cutout of the gun. So to make it so it's a snug fit, I cut 6 layers. So what I have is 2 layers with a little half circle cutout. I have a piece of the pen that's like tube going through 2 cutouts of a trigger that the trigger is glued to a spring that is glued to the side of this half circle. And so, as you can see, it's got a workable trigger. So now what I need to do is I need to put on the other 3 layers onto this side. So now I have, so that I'll have all 6 layers, and then I need to take this and glue it right there. And what that does is that once it's all together and I have the barriers and everything done, then you'll be able to just see this and it will look cool. So I have all the components made. I have this part made and this part made, and the magazine isn't going to be anything special. It's just going to hold in by being squeezed together a little bit by the siding. So that is what I've done. Now what I'm going to do is do what I just told you, the other 3 layers onto these layers, and then glue it in place right here. And then we are going to get into the tricky part of making this same piece here for the whole outer part of this gun here, just like I did for the stock. And then we are going to make braces on the inside of here just to brace the inside so it doesn't fold in. And then I'm going to glue the last layer on here. So I will show you what to do once I finish doing that. Alright, so as you can see, I equally distributed all 6 of the layers. I have 2 layers on both sides, 2 here and 2 here, and 2 in the middle. And then I made sure that none of the layers were showing, and I glued all 6 layers onto this side here. So as you can see, I have the workable trigger and the pullback side bolt action piece there. I don't really know the name. And so now what I have to do, and you're doing too, is we are going to cut 3 centimeter tall pieces just like this, but little ones that are going to be glued all around the inside of the gun, making sure there's still enough room for these types of pieces to go around the sides. And what those are braces, so that if somebody ever pushed down the gun, we would hate for this part to be hollow so that it would just squish in. We want to have it so it's nice and firm, just like the stock. So, and then once we're finished doing that, then what we're going to do is we're going to cut long strips of this, like about this size, a few of them, like 6 or 7, and we're going to glue them to the sides, shape them, glue them all the way from the handle down here all the way up, and then we're going to stop at the trigger guard, and we're going to slowly, carefully mold right here. But we're not going to mold right here because this part's already been done. And then we're going to mold right here all the way here, and we're going to stop right at the magazine part right here, because we want to leave this part empty. So no putting braces right here, because this is where the magazine's going to go in and out. And then we're going to put one here, all the way to here, down here, all the way to here, there, and right here, right here, right here. Then we're going to stop, and I'm not sure yet, but I might use cereal box cardboard for this little part here, because I really don't want this part here being messed up, because this part might not be thick enough for 3 centimeter, for because how thick these are is 0.5 centimeter, and I might not have enough room for this part here, so I might just have to use cereal box cardboard for this part to here. But I think you get the idea of what I'm doing. Do braces all around the gun except for right here where the piece is. And then what we're going to do next is really simple. I'm just going to glue the last layer on, and then we have to work on making the magazine, and then we have to do a lot of details and stuff. So yeah, so that's what you can do now, and we are almost finished the making of the Ump.45. As you can see, I finished putting the braces inside of one of the sides, and then I put the last layer on. So now what we have to work on is gluing the stock onto the back of the main body, and we have to make the magazine so it can easily slide in and out of the main body of the gun. Alright guys, so it probably looks like I've finished a lot of stuff since we first left off with I was showing you earlier. Well, actually, it's very simple what I've done. So as you can see, I have the magazine ready now. And okay, so what I did is we already had this part working, and we already had the trigger done. But now we needed to put the other side on. So how I did this, and it was very simple, is I put a bunch of braces. Sorry, my hands are kind of gunked up because I just finished painting the insides of the magazine, just so that once I paper mache everything, the insides are still black. So anyways, so I put braces on the middle, making sure not to get in the way of here. See, I left a spacing in there. But I put braces everywhere so that when I push down, it feels solid, like there is layers, but it's only two layers. So, and then after I finished putting the braces in, then I ran all the way up to here, foam core poster board side pieces, so that you would not see the inside of the gun, and it would just make it more firm. And then I put a piece of cereal box cardboard right here, because I didn't have enough room to put foam core poster board, which is 0.5 centimeter, so I had to use a thinner piece, which was cereal box, but only for that part. So to make the magazine, what I did is I had the two cutouts, right? I had one that had the rectangle in it, and I had one that didn't, which is on the picture. So I cut those out, and now what I did, and it was very simple, as you're probably looking at this and you're going, those are metal. Well, it's not actually metal. It's wooden dowel. So what I did is I cut them into little pieces that were just a little bit bigger than the hole here. I mean, not the hole, wow. The cutout rectangle, just a little bit bigger, and I cut about 8 of them or so, and then I glued them all together in a long line and painted them gold. And then I painted the inside of these two magazine layers black, just so that once I've paper mache everything, you won't see a bunch of white, you'll see actual black, just so that I don't have to worry about this later, because I won't be able to do it later. So then I made, just like I did here, I made sides here, and I went all the way around, and now, let's see if I can do it. Yeah, it goes a lot smoother with two hands, but as you can see, we have the whole gun laid out. The only thing we're missing is the sights. So now what I need to do is I need to move everything, and I need to paper mache it with school glue and either lined paper or newspaper, just a thin paper. And what you do is you take a brush, you sprinkle some school glue on, you brush it, and then you place down some notebook paper or something that are cut into little squares, and you lay them around and you mold them into the shapes, like right here, the bump and stuff, and you go all the way around and pay very close attention to detail, because this part will be covered up, so will this part. And then after you've done that, you just sand everything down lightly. And what I'm going to do is I'm not going to paper mache this part here, because this is the part that just fits in, so I'm going to paper mache right up to that little line right there. So now, and then after I finish doing that, then I'm going to paint it black after I put on some little dials and things here just to make it a little bit more realistic. And then I have to put on the wooden dowel piece in the front to look like the barrel. So we got a little bit longer to go in the making of the Ump.45, but we are pretty much done. Alright, so I just finished paper macheing it all, and as you can see, it's everywhere. I didn't do it right here though, in the insides, because that would have just taken a really long time, and it might have just messed it up even more. So, as you can see, there's a few things that are bending out, and hopefully I can fix those by sanding it afterwards. Just gotta sand those parts off. And I did the magazine, and what I did, and you're probably seeing this, is I did not paper mache the ends parts here. I just paper mache'd all the parts where two different foam core post board pieces had glued together. So, as you can see there's like a piece here that's glued to another piece. Well, I went over every single one of those pieces using this method all the way. I didn't do the insides of the trigger guard here because that would have taken too long. I didn't do in here because I don't want to mess up being able to put my magazine in and out. And I did everything. So now I'm just going to wait for it to dry. And once it's finished fully dry, I mean like fully dry, not even wet. Because if it's wet and you try to sand it, it's going to wreck it. So wait until it's fully dry. That may take like 5 hours, or it may take more. But once it's fully dry, you're just going to get sandpaper and you're going to just lightly go over all the parts that are uneven or a little bit weird. But the truth is, it's not going to come out perfect. Meaning, you're not going to have like perfect lines and everything. But the paint will cover it up because it's going to be black. But there will still be some parts that might stand out a little bit. But just not to worry though, because this is just a fun project. Plus, it's cool for movies. And depending on how fast you use this in the movie, and how, like, if it's like a running scene or a quick shooting scene, well, all you have to do is kind of blur the image just a tad. Not that much, but just a tad. And you won't see any like things that are you messed up on. But anyways, so I'm just going to wait for it to dry, and then I'm going to lightly sand everything down. Okay, so now all the paper mache is totally dry, and now I'm going to go lightly sand it, and then I'm going to add some knobs and things onto the side using foam core poster board. Alright, so as you can see, I'm a little bit of at a crunch for time right now because I only have like 2 minutes and 55 seconds to be able to finish this. But anyways, so this is really simple. I just cut out, using the measurements, a piece of foam core poster board that's a rectangle this big, and then cut little rectangles to glue onto it. And then I cut 2 rectangles glued into the bottom for this to stick out a little bit. And then I made these grips here. 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 8 in all. Yeah, 8 in all, because there's 2 underneath to make it stand up a bit. But yeah, after I finished making that, then I took a long rectangle, rolled it up of cereal box cardboard, and then I put a little rectangle, glued it to the very center, and then as you can see over here, I cut out a rectangle and a little square in the top, and they align. You get this for working sights. And then after I did that, I just glued a rectangle to the top here. It's very easy. And as you can see, it goes back just like the normal one, and it retracts back in form if you glue it in place. So that's pretty cool. And then I just glued this wooden dowel that I had previously from the M16 build, and just glued it to the front after I cut it down to the correct size. So here's the finished product. I just painted everything black. That's all I can say about it because it was very simple. So in the future, I might make an update or two if I ever change anything, but this is the finished product. Hope you guys liked the journey we went on making this gun. It was a lot of fun. Comment below what you think about it. And thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe, comment, rate. And if you are already subscribed, please stay tuned for more tutorials and requests on my channel if you would like any of your specific guns to be made. Thanks, guys. Hey guys, welcome to another prof tutorial by The Creative Bird. Today we're going to be working on a Ump.45 with a pull-out magazine, workable, wow,